On this week's episode of the Instagram poll tests, we had easily the closest vote I've ever seen in the history of this channel. Both having 73% yeses was Joshua's Birria Tacos and Babish's Cannolis. Keep in mind, thousands upon thousands of you vote on these now. So the fact that the winner was decided by 14 votes is ridiculous. And with 10,234 yes votes, Joshua's Birria Tacos, and with 14 more than that was Babish's Cannolis. Unfortunately, I had to order a bunch of stuff for that video that won't get here until next week, but it's fine, we'll have a Christmas cannoli episode, I guess. Today though, we are attacking Joshua Weissman's delicious looking Birria Tacos. And before you run down to the comments to criticize my pronunciation, get used to it. This episode's gonna be a bloodbath of me trying to say things between Birria Tacos, Queso Oaxaca, Guajillo Chilies. It's gonna be rough. We'll get through it together though, so let's get right into this one. If you are at home, snowed in like I am, and you'd like to make these, you're probably out of luck, because there's a lot of stuff that's going into this. You would need some masa and dried guajillo chilies, kosher salt and boneless chuck steaks, some good quality beef stock and dried red chilies, whole black peppercorns and vegetable oil, a cinnamon stick and bay leaves, some large oxtail pieces and bone-in short ribs, a large yellow onion, fresh garlic, coriander seeds, tomato paste, and queso Oaxaca. Now, hopefully you guys know that I try to be as honest and transparent with you as possible. So there are a few things I gotta address in this video. Number one are the chilies. In the recipe, Joshua said you should use 5 dried guajillo chilies, but also 5 dried ancho chilies as well. And if you remember, I had large bags of both of those from my Chipotle video, so I figured I'd be good, until I pulled the bag of ancho chilies out of my pantry and they were loaded with like buggy maggots. I don't know if something was in there when I bought them or I didn't close them airtight and something crawled in there, but it was not a sight that you would want to see. As a result, I'm just going to up the number of the other 2 chilies that I'm gonna be using today. And the second thing I'd like to address is the beef stock. For whatever reason, Joshua is super adamant about making your own beef stock for this recipe. Honestly, I don't have 8 hours to cook down a stock like I did for the BA Thanksgiving video. I just spent a couple extra dollars, I tried to get a decent quality beef stock, and honestly, I think it's gonna be just fine. In hindsight, like, I make these videos for you guys to see if these recipes online are really worth your time and money. And how many of you would actually make your own stock if you were to make this recipe? Probably close to none, so maybe it'll be a more accurate taste test result anyway, or let's just spin it that way to make me feel better. Now that I got that all off my chest, you guys have been watching me prepare all the vegetables, all the aromatics for my consomme broth. Between all of our onion and garlic, our chilies, our tomato paste, that super browned and like deeply golden beef, this thing is gonna be packed with flavor. The only other thing I'll say about this is, between you and I, if you can't find huge chunks of oxtail or like bone-in short ribs, I'm sure you can substitute out one, just up the ratio of the bone-in chuck steaks, like make do with what you can find and what you have. I was lucky enough to find a pound of all 3 meats that Joshua uses, and I was able to get a really nice dark crust on these. To do this, literally just put your stove on the highest setting with some oil, and as soon as that oil starts smoking, lay in all your beef. It's gonna smoke a lot and like splatter a little bit, but don't be afraid, because that's the way you get the best color. But like I said, this thing seems like it's going to be so incredibly flavorful. If all those ingredients in there wasn't enough, it's going to get simmered for an hour before I very carefully remove all of my chilies and then a few cups of the cooking liquid, blending that together. And then once that gets reincorporated, it simmers away for another 90 minutes until that meat is basically falling apart and your whole house smells like the most delicious soup kitchen or taco shop you've ever stepped foot in. Now, while I let that go for the second time, I started to work on my homemade corn tortillas. At least I can say I did this, since even Joshua uses some store-bought tortillas as far as I can tell. I just don't really love the taste or texture of store-bought corn tortillas specifically, so I saw this super easy recipe online. Of course, I'll leave it down in the description, but it's a mixture of the masa, salt, some hot water, and vegetable oil. It's really simple. I would say that there's two secrets while making these. Number one, if you're like me and you don't have a tortilla press, all you need is a clear glass pie tray and some plastic wrap. It makes it super easy to spread nice and evenly, and you can see right through the glass, so you can tell when you're at your desired thickness. And the second secret is the way you cook them. Ditch the nonstick pans. You're gonna need either a stainless steel, a cast iron, maybe one of those copper pans might work, but you need this as hot as possible. You're trying to retain as much moisture as you can in these so they don't dry out and start cracking on you. So literally 20 seconds on each side max. Just look for some of that leopard spotting, take it off, and then cover it with some airtight plastic wrap. Just keep in as much of that moisture as you can. Now that the tortillas are ready to go and our meat has finally finished braising for close to 3 hours, I took them out and the tenderness on these cuts of beef are just indescribable. I don't know if I've ever made something that just wants to like fall apart as easily as these guys. The bone just basically falls off of it. I am once again having to test my self-control and not start eating this on the spot. But I moved over to my Oaxaca cheese. I started to shred little pieces of that. It's almost uncanny how much this spool of cheese resembles those pieces of string cheese that we used to have in our kindergarten lunchboxes. And now it is time for the main event. I carefully dipped one tortilla at a time into my consomme, fatty, delicious beef mixture. Laid it down onto my still hot cast iron skillet. I loaded that up with some cheese and let that melt a little bit. Definitely not necessary at all, but a blowtorch does help you in this situation. And then I finished it off by covering half with some of our shredded up beef mixture. I don't know if I've mentioned this, but I've never had a birria taco, but the fact that I am snowed in right now, I've been salivating for an hour, and these look like they should be on the cover of some food magazine, I am ready to not be able to say that anymore. If this is not good, it might be one of the all-time worst fails or like worst results because I have such high expectations for this one. Just based alone on how tender that meat was, how amazing this smells. Oh, I still have a glove on. Let's get a nice dip. I actually forgot to put a little bit of extra in with the meat and the cheese before I folded up the taco, but when you like drown it in this anyway, it doesn't really matter. You guys hear that? Don't know what's happening. Holy f- Hold on. I think it goes without saying that I like this. Quite a bit, actually. It's got such a nice balance of like salty to richness to chili heat on the back end. It's so good. Oh man. Just that alone is so good. It's got such a deep, complex, like addictive quality to it. It tastes like something that's been like boiling off for days and just reducing and reducing, but it's just store-bought stock, some seared meat and chilies. This is a winner, guys. Absolute 10 out of 10. Highly recommend. Good shit, Joshua. I love Santa hats, but my hair always looks so stupid in them. It looks like I just like placed a bob of hair toupee right there. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, leave me a big like. As I mentioned, Babish's cannolis are coming next week. Hopefully that'll be a nice little Christmas holiday special for you all. If you don't follow me on Instagram and Twitter already, the links are down in the description. And other than that, have a fantastic weekend, and I will see you right back here next time. Peace! Super lazy, try and make a meal tonight, they ain't paying me, try and supersize my life with my A-team, yeah our style wasn't wavy but we had a vision.